Good evening. This is Amanda Manier with the Veterans Law Group. This is the Veterans Voice, and we are actually live here this evening. I had requested to specifically be live due to a couple of things, like the Veterans Day tomorrow and the Marine Corps birthday that is happening today. And so if you are a listener, somebody who is listening, or whether you're a veteran or you're not, we're going to do a bit of a tribute show tonight to veterans in our community and veterans that are impactful in our lives. Tell you a little bit about the show before we get started. The Veterans Voice is kind of a heart project for me. I'm a veteran advocate and an attorney at the Veterans Law Group. I work with every single one of my clients are veterans who are pursuing their disability benefits claims through the VA and are kind of struggling through that process. But in addition to that, one of the great honors that I have is to work with veterans. Many of our paralegals and people who work with us are veterans or family members of veterans, spouses, parents, children. So we all know directly kind of what the veterans are going through. So it's been an honor of mine for a number of years to serve veterans. And this week is one of those that every single year it falls on November 10th to be the Marine Corps birthday. I believe this is 246th year of the Marines. And so all of you Marines out there, happy birthday. We always say once a Marine, always a Marine, even if you served in the 70s, 60s, a long time ago. We are here to honor you and to say happy birthday to all the Marines out there. In addition to that, tomorrow we celebrate Veterans Day, and President Eisenhower, I believe, is who first signed a bill into law that said we were going to, as a nation, honor veterans every single year on November 11th. And one of the interesting things that I love to work with or to talk with veterans out there is kind of what that means to you, whether it is something that is honoring, whether it's something that feels uncomfortable. I definitely get different perspectives on that from different people as to whether or not they feel uncomfortable when somebody says thank you for your service, or what are better things to say. So generally on the show, we're highlighting organizations that are supporting veterans. We often interview people who served, talk a little bit about their career, what they're doing now, and then answer questions. To those of you out there who have questions about disability benefits, just navigating the process with the VA. So again, we're live this evening. So if you've got any of those things that you want to call in, honor a veteran, ask a question, we're at 800-5222 or 222-5222. And I believe that, do we have Star with us yet? Star, are you on the line?
Yes, I am.
Wonderful.
Can you hear
thank
me?
You so much for joining us. Yes, I can hear you. Thank you so much for joining us. And to just do a brief introduction to those of us who are listening, Star is a U.S. Air Force veteran, and she has been a paralegal that's worked with us, helping with veterans navigate the process. And I always like to give a little bit of an introduction, and instead of speaking for you, can you give us a little quick rundown of your military career, where you served, when you served?
Yeah, so I served for 4 years with the United States Air Force at Edwards Air Force Base, and I did one tour overseas. So I did do an overseas to the Middle East.
Okay, and what part of the Middle East?
So it was to basically the UAE area.
Okay. And what did you do in while you were in the military? Tell us a little bit about your service.
So I was security forces and law enforcement in the military for all 4 years.
And then when you got out, I understand you went through paralegal school and then ended up helping and supporting veterans as they navigate the process that you're very familiar with.
Yes. It kind of fell in my lap, trying to figure it out myself. And then as I was just kind of getting into the process, going to school and going for my master's for criminal justice, I got into working with people that were like, hey, you know, become a paralegal. And then they told me that there is actually a law that, you know, there's attorneys and everything that handle the law for the VA disability. And so that's how I got to know the Veterans Law Group and get into working with you guys for a little under 6 years.
Yeah. And what's amazing is that I had, I've been an attorney since 2003, and I had worked for many, many years in the business law sector and didn't even know that this was an area of law that lawyers could get involved in, just like you had said, you didn't know. And what I find out a lot of times, veterans don't know that there are attorneys who can help them through this process. There are also veteran service organizations out there that help. What generally happens when people come to us is they're dealing with a little more difficult cases or cases in which we need to go out and get them independent exams, and we would essentially spend the money to get them what they need in order to get their case where they need to be. I know you probably know a number of Marines as well. How important, knowing from a, you know, military perspective, how important is the Marine Corps birthday to the Marines?
Oh, yeah. It's very important. Every Marine knows the Marine birthday. Like, they know everything about the Marines that you could know. It's drilled into them.
Definitely. And it's funny because I find it so interesting that runs right up against Veterans Day. But we must recognize Marine Corps birthday before we talk about Veterans Day, as all the Marines that I've known, which many of them are definitely amazing. So, again, happy birthday to all the Marines out there. And again, we're live this evening. We're taking call-ins. If you'd like to call in and just give a little bit of a tribute to somebody in your life who has, you'd like to honor, who's a family member, a friend, any of those, it's going to be more of a tribute show than it is to digging into education, that kind of thing. But, you know, we can also go into that if somebody has a question about their case. We're just going to kind of honor what everybody needs at this point. I'll give you the opportunity, Star. I've got a couple here, but I'm going to give you the opportunity here to honor a veteran in your life. If you would like to tell us who that is, their name, what branch they served in, when they served, where they served, I'm going to kick it over to you to start it off.
Yeah, so I would like to honor my grandfather. His name was Claire Bowen, and he was in the United States Navy. He was in it from 1942 until 1963. He served in World War II, Korea, and Vietnam. His favorite thing to talk about was that he was part of the Four Horsemen in World War II. So it was like the four ships that were like the elite ships during that time frame. We did just lose him this year. So it's a hard Veterans Day.
Yeah. He lived a very full life. He was 90 what when he died?
He was 99. Well, 98. Wow. I take that back. He was almost 99. Almost made it to 99.
And I had the honor of meeting him a couple of times, and it's very rare, one, that you even meet a World War II veteran these days directly, but also somebody who served, you know, multiple wars, multiple services over the years. And I know that he was a role model for you and a support to you and just an overall amazing man. I mean, everybody still talks in our office about the last time he came, and everybody got to meet him, and we have a picture of him on our refrigerator. So it was definitely an honor to be able to get to meet him. Anything else you want to say as far as him or anybody else that you want to give a tribute to before I go or we go on to break?
Just a tribute. Well, basically my husband and his family, because it's all military. So the Borsa family, because my husband was Air Force, his father was Air Force, and then all of his uncles are Navy, Army, Marine Corps. So a shout out to all of them, because That whole side of the family, you know, they took up every branch possible, and even one of his aunts served in the Army, I believe, and so it's one of the families that, you know, it's just, we're very proud of just the service and the sacrifice that they've all made.
Yeah, definitely, and including you, you know, as an Air Force veteran yourself. Like, I know you're not going to give tribute to yourself, but I'm going to throw that out to you of the time that you gave to the country. And I know you and all of the people that you just mentioned, I'm sure but many of them are, you know, post-service, still dealing with things related to service. And it's one of those things that you know, everybody kind of jokes about once a Marine, always a Marine. But in reality, that's kind of true for all branches of service. It's, you never really let go of that. It doesn't ever really stop being a part of your identity once you give your life of, you know, it's, I was thinking about this today as I was walking is, you know, I go to a job every day and I go home, and, you know, when I go home, I get to check out. And when you sign up for the military, you sign up 24/7 for the 4 years or 6 years or 12 years or 20 that you serve. You know, for lack of a better, belong to the military. And that's why, you know, and you just get paid crap. We've talked about that. And it comes down
exactly
to the things about, you know, the contracts that we as civilians sign with people who serve in the military, that we're going to take care of you. We're going to do what we need to do to take care of you for anything that you, you know, any disability or any injury. I shouldn't even just call it disability, an injury that you incur while you're providing service to us. So, definitely thank you. And thank you to your family for, you know, serving and for providing that, you know, a family of service and a history of service. So, good evening, Los Angeles. This is Amanda Manier with the Veterans Voice. I am a veteran advocate and attorney and the host here of the Veterans Voice. Typically, when we have these shows, we have either, you know, a guest on as a veteran talking about their history and their service, answering questions about VA disability benefits, or highlighting organizations that are supporting veterans in unique ways. This evening on November 10th, the 246th birthday of the U.S. Marine Corps, we are honoring the Marines, and tomorrow is the Veterans Day, where we are supporting and highlighting and honoring veterans all across the country, no matter what branch that they served. And it's an honor this evening to welcome Star, who is a U.S. Air Force veteran, a paralegal, and somebody that I know relatively well, who's helping me host the show tonight. One of the things that we've been trying to do and really wanting to do this evening is, instead of getting into the kind of the nitty-gritty and doing education, is I want to spend some time honoring veterans in our lives and in your lives. So we are live this evening. If you would like to call in and give a tribute to a veteran in your life that you would like to give a shout-out to or a tribute to, you can call us at 800-222-5222. We'd love to take your call. Star, are you back with us?
Yes.
Awesome. So thank you so much. Before we went to the break, we were honoring your grandfather, World War II veteran, served all the way through Korea, Vietnam, and recently passed. So we're sorry for your loss on that, but I understand that you were, honestly understand that you are, you know, feeling his presence today, tomorrow, and then also just your family that has served, honorably served in the Air Force, and your husband's family as well. So thank you for coming back with us and just being a part of this show. I wanted to ask you, as you know, I'm not a veteran myself. I am surrounded by them. But one of the things that get asked to me a lot when I do interviews and, you know, PR and stuff is, what do you, you know, what can the public do, and what, how can they support veterans on Veterans Day or just in general? And a big question is always like, you know, what is it? People say, oh, thank you for your service. And I know different veterans have different perspectives on that, but I would love to hear yours on when somebody says thank you for your service, is that awkward? Does it feel weird? Would you rather they send something else? Give me your feedback on that.
Yeah, so I think it all depends on the person, because, like, for me, I like hearing thank you for your service. It's just awkward not knowing, like, what to say back sometimes, because it's like, you know, you're saying thank you back for saying thank you for something, so, and then you don't want to be rude by not saying anything. So it's kind of like there's always that awkward situation of, like, okay, well, you know, what is to be said? So a lot of people just... I think a lot of veterans just feel awkward in the sense that they're like, eh, I don't know. I like the fact that people thank me, just not because I'm like, it's more of, you know, I'm proud of my service, not that I feel that I have gone above and beyond anyone else that has done it. I feel that there's a lot more people out there, like my grandfather, who did a heck of a lot more than I ever did. And I think that's why my husband, like, he's the opposite way. Like, he feels very weird when people thank him. He's one of those that shies away from it. So sometimes, like, one of the things that we have discussed over, like, time and time again on Veterans Day is, you know, a lot of different places will do, like, a free appetizer or something like that. Like, we normally don't go out and celebrate that just because, like, for my husband, like, you know, he doesn't feel comfortable with that, and everybody, you know, saying thank you and bring it up. My grandfather, on the other hand, he loved it because he just got, it was like his day to kind of talk some more about everything. Right. So I think it's really based on the veteran. It's based on their service. Like, you know, how they felt about their service, how they came out of the military. A lot of things, instead of, like, to support veterans, a lot of times, you know, it's kind of like that leave a drink ahead of time for somebody, you know, not necessarily, you know, or like if you see a veteran in a store, like, you know, send them a coffee or something like that. I think that, especially for the older generation, means a lot more because, like I, with my grandfather, those were the little things, you know, just like a dollar cup of coffee, like no creamer, no sugar. So that's how they like it, especially the Marines and the Navy. They want their black coffee. you know, you send that over and without making a big deal about it, but just that small little gesture, or, you know, doing Veteran Day cards that you send in. So when they do the parade and they pass them out, you know, it's something that they get that they can look at on their own, because sometimes it brings up some feelings, you know, they've, a lot of them have a lot of different things that they go through, and some of them don't want to remember everything they've gone through. So Veterans Day is a really hard time because it brings up a lot of feelings and emotions.
Yeah. And I think a lot of times it's an opportunity for us as civilians and Americans to stop and recognize and honor them. And everybody gets very patriotic. If you looked at any sort of news over the last week, even those that, you know, maybe, you know, are kneeling to the flag and all that kind of thing, they're standing up and saluting veterans no matter what. And I think that's very honorable, that it's something that we recognize. But I often think about, I was just talking to my mom about this, so that I often think about, you know, Vietnam veterans who, when they came home, they were, because the war was so controversial, they were told, you know, to, you know, keep your mouth shut, don't tell people you were in the military, don't tell people you were in Vietnam. And we live in a different world now where I love seeing a veteran wearing a Vietnam veteran hat. And I feel like those are the ones especially to reach out to buy them a cup of coffee, to thank them for their service. Because when they came home, they were not given the Heroes Parade when they came home. And often had to hide a lot of their disabilities, like PTSD. I mean, Vietnam was a horrific war. They're all horrific, but horrific war.
Yeah.
To then come home and be told, you know, I mean, we have Agent Orange. We had the drug use that was happening, all of that. And I... and maybe I have a particular heart for them because I understand that my uncle was in the Vietnam War, got drafted. And interestingly enough, it was only just a couple of years ago. My dad is 68 years old, and it was just a couple of years ago. I happened to ask him, you know, how did you not end up in the Vietnam War? And he told me that his brother had gotten drafted, and he went to go sign up and volunteer to go. And when he came home and told his mom freaked out and was like, don't go. And that was the only reason why he didn't go. And I was telling my mom that, and my mom has been married to my dad for 47 years, and she's like, I've never heard that story. And he happened to tell me just in the like small little conversation that we had. So it was a very interesting time. And you know, and within the last year, my uncle died as well. And I didn't ever know him well. He was not really close to anybody. But my dad did say he came back as a different person, and the effects of the Vietnam War on him. And so I think sometimes in recognizing, you know, Veterans Day, it seems almost weird to say Happy Veterans Day. It's more like, exactly. I want to just honor veterans on Veterans Day. It's like, let's stop and remember. And, it, you know, it's different from Memorial Day. And Memorial Day, we remember those who were lost in during their service. And during Veterans Day, it's, you know, let's honor those who served and recognize the fact that, like I said earlier, your service doesn't end. It's just like the, you know, we talked about with the Marines. They don't, once Marine, always Marine. Really, once a military service member, that's going to carry with you throughout your entire life. And I imagine that's true for you and your husband.
Oh, yes. There's a lot of things that never go away. Yes.
Yeah. Well, and if you're listening in right now, we are live, and we would love to take your tributes to a veteran in your family or somebody that you want to honor it. You can call in at 800-222-5222 if you want to call in and give a little bit of a tribute. During our last couple minutes, I would like to do that and just give an example as Star has with her family. I've worked with veterans in this industry for 8 years full time, a couple of years prior to that. If you've ever heard my story or listened to this radio show, there was a veteran friend of mine in my life. And at the time that I met him, he was in the military and he had served about 18 months in Iraq. It was during the time that people were serving that long. He was the first to deploy from his unit and the last to come home. And just came back as a different person. He was U.S. Army infantry, served from 2006 to 2010. He struggled a lot with PTSD, struggled a lot with having the ability to work when he came home, tried to, always was very an honorable person who wanted to be able to take care of himself. He never wanted a handout. It was a really hard thing for him to ask the VA for help with unemployability, and he's the one that opened this door to me that I ended up learning about this area of law and getting into it. And so I'm not going to mention his name. I don't want to expose his privacy, but he's somebody that's very dear to me, that I am thankful that I got into this area of law. So good evening, Los Angeles. This is Amanda Manier with the Veterans Voice. I am a veteran advocate and attorney with the Veterans Law Group, and I am the host here of the Veterans Voice. And one of my things that we do on the show is a couple of things on a general week-to-week basis is to talk about veterans benefits. That's what we do full time, is to help veterans through the VA disability process. I also like to highlight nonprofits that are helping veterans just in all aspects of life, and then talking with and interviewing people who have served, their family members, and just honoring them. One of the great things about this week is not only is today the 10th of November, the Marine Corps birthday, but tomorrow is Veterans Day. So we are live this evening, and we are doing a tribute show to veterans in your lives and in ours. And if you'd like to do a tribute, call in and just let us know who was the veteran here in your life. Feel free to contact us at 800-222-5222. I'm also joined this evening by a co-host, guest, friend, a Star, who is a U.S. Air Force veteran. She's also joining us. Star, are you still with us?
Yes.
Awesome. So I understand we have a couple of calls that have come in, and we'd like to take them and see what we've got to say. So Roy, is it Roy, I believe, on line one? Ron, I'm sorry. Ron?
Yes, hello.
Hi, Ron. Thank you so much for joining us. How are you this evening?
I'm doing very well. How about yourselves?
Pretty good. Do you have a tribute to a veteran in your family or a comment, or what would you like to bring to the table?
Yeah, two things. The first is a tribute to my military family for 200 years plus of service from the Revolutionary War all the way through my father that was in World War II, my brother in Vietnam. I have nephews still in the military, children, so a very stacked military family. So the Revolutionary War, I had an uncle that was a brigadier general. His name was John Sevier. My grandfather, he died at a battle at King's Mountain in the 1767 era. And so our family still lives through that very beginning and all the way till today. I have never been part of the military, but have been part of all of their lives. So, many generations that I would like to give a tribute to.
That's awesome, and thank you so much, and for calling in, for honoring them. It's one of those things that, years and years ago, so many people in our families served, and it's, I think, somewhat become less and less, maybe because of less need or less population, or not even the draft, but yeah, I'm definitely super honored for, my grandfather was also a World War II veteran, and it's funny because I don't even really think about that because I didn't really know him personally, but it's something that I would love to look into his history on, and it sounds like you've looked into your history going all the way back to the Revolutionary War, which is awesome. All right, Bill, on line two. You with us?
Good evening. Can you hear me?
Good. I can hear you, Bill. Go ahead.
Thank you. It's actually Mel, but it sounds like Bill sometimes.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. Thank you, and I hope you will put out information for us to be able to contact you. Sadly, there's a lot of homeless veterans, and we treat invaders better than we do our own veterans. I'd like to give a shout out to another veteran, Rob Rosebrock, who has been helping veterans for 13 years. He's been at the VA every Sunday. That's over 600 some Sundays.
Wow.
And for putting the American flag up so other people could know to come out and help him, he's been half of them arrested for putting the American flag on the American taxpayers paid fence at the VA at West LA. And he's really a nice guy. He's written a little book about some of his thoughts.
Well, I would love, and I'm going to put out to you guys right now publicly, and I hope you can hear it. If not, then you can definitely see our website, but veteranslaw.com. I would love to talk to him. I would love to, see what we can do to help him for sure. And again, veteranslaw.com is our contact information. And if you say at all when you contact us, either phone or email, that you talk to me on the radio show. That'll come directly to me. And Mel, I would love to either get more information from you to help you or to, you know, see what he's doing, because that's pretty amazing that he's doing that.
Thank you. Is there a phone number that you feel comfortable to give out over the air, or I could tell you I'm not...
You're kind of cutting out a little. You're kind of cutting out a little bit, but I will give you a phone number. It's 888-811-0523. It's
888-811-0523. Thank you.
That is a number to our office, and when you call us, definitely mention that you and I spoke on the radio show, okay?
I just came here. I just found you. Tell me your name. You're Amanda?
My name is Amanda, yes, and you're cutting out a little bit. So, yeah, definitely contact us via phone and mention that you spoke with Amanda on the Veterans Voice, and they'll put you through to me, okay?
If I may ask you something, too, I have a very dear friend that didn't come home. He never saw his 21st birthday. I'm trying to contact him. He was a year ahead of me in high school. I graduated in 64. He graduated in 63, and I called the school, and I said, I've got plenty of good ID, no crime record or anything. Could you please put me in touch with his family? And they said, we cannot get out that information to anybody. I said,
you're cutting out a little bit, so I just want to try to address your question. And again, if you call our office, I might be able to help you more directly. There's some research that we can do that might be able to help you make that connection. But again, call our office, and we can dig into that a little further for sure. And I know Star, who's with us here on the call, that would be a perfect project for her to help you work on. She would, I'm sure, Star, if you're listening, you would probably love to dig into helping him find somebody.
Definitely. There are some ways we can make that happen.
Sure. I believe we're coming up on a break, but let's see if we can take one more call. Is Myron? Myron on line 3?
Yeah, that's me, and thank you very much. I love your observation about how once you serve, it becomes a fundamental part of your identity for your whole life.
Mm-hmm.
And that is so spot on. My dad was World War II veteran. My grandfather, World War I and World War II. And that's what's on his tombstone.
Wow.
That was who he was, and he defined himself that way. Observation very quickly is how our nation, how America, has matured so much since Vietnam in how we treat our veterans. Back when I got out, which was in 75, we just wanted to blend in. I mean, we were baby killers. We were, why would you do that? Why would you waste your life? And blah, blah, blah. You don't hear that anymore. You hear, thank you for your service. You hear, we appreciate what you've done. And that feels good. It really does, both personally and also as an American, to know that military service is venerated once again. And it wasn't always that way in very recent history. Yeah. So,
I appreciate your comment. I don't know if you heard me talking earlier that I have a huge heart for Vietnam veterans, because you guys were told to come when you came back, don't talk about your service. And so you didn't come home with the parades and the support and the heroes welcome home. It was such a controversial war, and there was such, so I reach out intentionally to Vietnam veterans to thank you for the sacrifice that you made. And I appreciate you so much, Myron, in calling in. And I know that, I'm sorry, we're having to go up to a break. It's the radio thing.
No, okay.
But thank you so much for calling in, and thank you for your service and your family's service for sure. Yeah, this is Amanda Minear. I am with the Veterans Voice, and this is 790 KABC. Good evening, Los Angeles. This is Amanda Minear with the Veterans Voice here on 790 KABC. We are doing a special tribute this evening for two different things. One is the Marine Corps birthday, which is this evening, the 246th birthday of the Marine Corps. And a preview to tomorrow, Veterans Day, we as a nation honor veterans, hopefully, and respect them. One of the really interesting things that I found in working in this industry, I'm a veteran attorney, veteran advocate. We help veterans with their disability benefits through the appeals process of some of those more struggling cases. We work really closely with a lot of veteran service organizations and county veteran service officers. And that's very interesting, as I've recognized over the years that so many of them actually don't get Veterans Day off, which is really interesting. And our office has a rule, if the VA is closed, we're closed. So tomorrow, all of the veterans that I work with within our company get the day off. And our clients, I will be there in case our clients need something. But we are honoring veterans this evening. And I'm asking people who are listening, we're live. And if you'd like to call in and give you a tribute to a veteran in your family or a veteran just has impacted your life, you can call in at 800-222-5222. And I understand that we have somebody on the line right now that would like to give a tribute. We're also joined by Star, who's a co-host. She can chime in if she wants to. But John, are you with us?
Yes, ma'am, I am.
Okay, John, who would you like to give a tribute to?
Can you hear me, ma'am?
I can hear you, yes.
Okay. I turned the radio off, you know, the AM radio, but This is fine. I guess just do it by phone. This is just like now.
Yes, I can hear you great. Yes, I can hear
okay,
you great.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am, I am a veteran from Vietnam era. I was not in Vietnam myself, but I was airborne infantry with some time in the Ranger Command as well, and spent time with Recon Marines and SEALs. They're my brothers. We were not honored to have females at that time. But so I'll say my brothers. Forgive me if I keep saying my brothers, because all the
no problem. Yeah.
This is not about me, ma'am, but I have to say, a lot of us, I was one, there was no such thing as post-traumatic stress back at that time. So, you know, I did what I had to do and came off active duty. I completed my active duty obligation, was planning to go on the GI Bill and then go back in special warfare. But I found something remarkable, something extraordinary. And I completed through the reserves, because I didn't even have any time I had to do in the reserves. But I parted company amicably with Sam. And I love Sam, and I love my country. Yeah. What I found, and the reason I'm calling tonight, is this can maybe help my brothers and sisters now, because they've been through to hell and back in Iraq and Afghanistan. So many beautiful sisters as well. Yeah. I'll be brief, because it isn't about me. There's something that I found. It's called the Peace Education Program. It's done through the Prem Rawat Foundation. It can be accessed. Ways to find out about it, access it, is the following. I'll just give it to you quick. T like tango, P like Papa, R like Romeo, F like Foxtrot. TPRF.org. O like Oscar, R like Romeo, G like Golf. TPRF.org. They have a peace education program. It can be accessed online. It's free. It doesn't just help veterans, but I, as a veteran, and a lot of my veteran friends have taken benefit from the message of peace that is provided there. It is not therapy. It's not a psychological modality. It's not conditioning of some kind. It just helps people to contact the core of their being, find inner peace and contentment. And I'll tell you, if you need therapy, get it. If you need any kind of medical help, get it. But I was honored to bring, and this I'll say about myself, to bring that program as a facilitator to the Los Angeles VA for 6 years, to the homeless facilities in L.A. And God knows my brothers who don't have a roof over their head, the VA took care of us. And I wasn't one of them. I had a place. I'm doing pretty okay. I found this thing, though, and it has helped me slowly for many, many years. And I brought it as a facilitator to the Los Angeles VA, and my brothers, and there were sisters at that VA, of course, because they take everybody from World War II through till the present day at the Los Angeles VA. Mm-hmm. So many of them just loved the program that I just wanted to give a shout-out for it. Say, go to tprf.org. And
I so appreciate that, Don, because like I said, I'm regularly wanting to highlight organizations that are supporting veterans in that way. And this is one I'm not familiar with, but I will check out because I know, there's been a lot of stuff going on in Los Angeles with homeless veterans and around the VA and the encampments and all of that kind of thing. And it's so, I can feel your enthusiasm, your energy that this is something that really, really helped you. And that's, one of the things like I look at all the time of, I can only help from a VA compensation perspective. We can help give you some financial stability. That doesn't resolve your problems, but it may be to give you a foundation to be able to then seek out organizations like this because you know that your children are being taken care of. So I will definitely look at that and look into that. And if it's something that we feel like we can support, we will post it on our, 790K ABC page for people who are interested in it for sure. So I definitely appreciate you. And, we talked earlier with Star of like, how do you say thank you for your service? And I always just, I want to say thank you for your sacrifice. Like you definitely, you and your life, your family, your children sacrificed to serve our country in a very honorable way. And like you said, it's when you served, the PTSD thing wasn't even really acknowledged. And thankfully it is now. But I work with veterans every single day from the Vietnam era who are just engaging in the PTSD dialogue. So thank you so much for this resource. And thank you again for your call and for your service.
Amanda, I need to make something clear before we... It's got to be straight and it's got to be correct. Mm-hmm. This that I told you about is not exclusively for veterans. The Broward Foundation is a 501c3. It's a charitable organization. They offer something called the Peace Education Program, which helps prisoners to find peace in their lives.
Okay.
It helps all kinds of advantaged and disadvantaged people, but it works so beautifully for veterans because God knows we did what we did. The lady who doesn't know what to say, what I want to say is you're thanking me for my service, but it was such an honor for me to express my love for my country, Airborne Ranger Infantry. That's, to me, all I could do, and it was my privilege to be able to give. And thank God I made it back in one piece. I'm alive. It's like 50-plus years later, and I'm grateful to be here. But this thing that I'm telling you about has helped me to find the source inside that made me love my country so much that I wanted to do it.
And that's
made
so beautiful.
Love my fellow human beings.
That's so beautiful, John. I will definitely. I'm thankful to you for giving me that resource, and I'm going to look into it and disseminate that to the people that I know, for sure. And I appreciate again your service. I know we're coming up against a break, but I think we have one more call. Let's try to squeeze him in, Gabe. Can you join us?
Hey, good evening. Thank you for taking the call. I just wanted to say thank you to all the men and women in uniform that have served on active duty, as well as I'm a service provider for the county in a Department of Mental Health. Mm-hmm. And I guess Dr. Sharon, Dr. Souther, Dr. McKnight, and the current program manager of Jim Zenner, we operate a county-based veteran program through the Department of Mental Health, and it can be accessed at the
I love county you guys. I actually am very aware of you guys, and I love you guys. You guys do great work. I refer people to you all the time. So, yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah, absolutely. And thank you so much. And we've got just, less than a minute left. And Star, really quickly, I know that you're with us. Is there anything you want to, just say publicly to your veteran community?
Yeah, I just wanted to say happy birthday to the Marines one more time. Shout out to all of you guys. And then to all of my veterans that are listening to the show, I wanted to say thank you to everybody out there. You guys are what make this country great. You're what has made this country survive and keep going. And so thank you all for your service. And I love my job and working with all of the veterans because you guys are all so amazing. So if you ever need any help, hit up the Veterans Law Group.
Our only agenda is giving you a voice. KABC, Los Angeles, Orange County.